this is the question again related to the Indian history. Consider the following events in the history of India and what is the correct chronological order about these events, starting from the earliest times. Rise of Pratihars under King Bhoj, establishment of Pallava power under Mahendra Varman I, establishment of Chola power by Prantaka I, and the last one is the Pal dynasty founded by Gopal. And the correct answer is C, 2413. This was the earliest. Then came the Pal dynasty, then the one, and then the last one, third, establishment of Chola power. Now I will show all these four events in our history booklet. First, History of India by bestcurrentaffairs.com for iSpellings 2020, page number 54. Here it is written, the Pallavas of Kanchi, Mahendra Varman, 600 to 625 AD. Now, the next page, 59. Page number 59 of Indian History Booklet by bestcurrentaffairs.com. Here the Cholas and Prantaka 1, 907 to 955. Page number 59, History of India. Then come to the page number 62 of the same book. Pratihars. They were in the 8th to 10th century. The Pratihar power regained its lost glory only after the succession of the Mihir Bhoj, popularly known as King Bhoja. He had a long reign of 46 years. Next statement is about the Palas, that the Pal Empire was founded by Gopal in 755 AD. So when you sequence all these events according to their chronological history, then the correct answer that is formed is 2413. C is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. The Gandhi-Irwin Pact included which of the following? The first one is the invitation to the Congress to participate in the Roundtable Conference. This is correct. Our Indian History Booklet for Indian Polity, page number 181. Gandhi-Irwin Pact. In this time, Indian National Congress called off the civil disobedience movement and agreed to join the second round table conference. So the statement 1 is correct. So when you correct the statement, you are left with two options, 1 only, 1 to 4. Now take this fourth one, release of prisoners who were not charged with violence. Now again come back to our Indian History Booklet, same page, Gandhi-Irwin Pact. Government on its part agreed to release the political prisoners. So statement 4 is also correct. So you are left with the option that contains 1, 4 and 2. Therefore B is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. This is the question. With reference to the chemical fertilizers in India, consider the following statements. First is that at present, the retail price of chemical fertilizers is market driven and not administered by the government. This statement is wrong. Open our May 2020 current affairs booklet, page number 15. Here it is clearly written, nutrient based subsidy rates. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs chaired by the Prime Minister has given its approval for the fixation of nutrient based subsidy rates for phosphatic fertilizers. Here again it is clearly written, government is making available fertilizer, namely urea and 21 grades of P and K fertilizers to farmers at a subsidized prices through fertilizer scheme. So the retail prices of these fertilizers are not market driven, they are administered by the government. So this statement is wrong. So when you remove this 1 from the options, you are left with B and C. 2 is common. Now we will first check the C, this option 3, sulfur. It says that sulfur, which is a raw material for fertilizer, and sulfur, it is a byproduct of oil refinery. So there are 2 points in the statement. We will show you the both. Now take the first one, sulfur, it is a raw material for fertilizer. For this, open our February 2020 current affairs book, page 143. February 2020 current affairs booklet, page 143. There was a new soil health card, and it is clearly written that improving fertilizer nutrient use efficiency is important. Rather than applying more fertilizer in Indian agriculture, nutrient use efficiency presently is low, ranging from 30-50% nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and sulfur. So sulfur is mentioned here that it is used in the fertilizers. So that point is correct, that sulfur, it is a raw material for fertilizer, it is correct. Now the second part of this, the same statement, that sulfur, it is a byproduct of oil refineries. For this, open our Indian Environment book, page number 14. Indian Environment booklet, my best currentaffairs.com, page number 14. This sulfur, the complete reasons for this sulfur are given, that these are air pollutants also. Combustion of sulfur containing fuel, coal, petroleum extraction and refining. Several times in our books it has been mentioned that sulfur is a byproduct of refining. So when you burn this fuel, petroleum fuel, during the oil refining process, sulfur is produced. So this part is also correct, that sulfur, it is a byproduct of oil refinery. So 3 is correct. And now you are left with the option B, 2 and 3. We will also show you the option 2, that it is also correct. For this, you need to open page number 28 of our environment book, the same book, page number 28. Indian Environment book for IS prelims, page number 28. Ammonia, it is used in fertilizers. Here it is clearly mentioned that ammonia is used in fertilizers. So this option is also correct. 2 and 3 is correct. B is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. This is the question. With reference to the history of India, consider the following pairs, famous places and their states. First one is Bhilsa, Madhya Pradesh. It is correct. Open our history booklet, page number 80. History of India by bestcurrentaffairs.com, page number 80. Here this Bhilsa is mentioned, Alauddin Khilji time. First expedition of Bhilsa, it is also known as Vidisha. Bhilsa is also known as Vidisha. And now come on the page number 33 of the same booklet, Indian History, page number 33, History of India, page number 33. Here it is mentioned that this Vidisha is in Madhya Pradesh. So Bhilsa is also known as Vidisha, and this Vidisha is in Madhya Pradesh. So that is why first statement is correct. So 1 is correct. Now you have left with the only 2 options, 1 A and B. Now check this fourth one, Sthaneshwar, Uttar Pradesh. it is wrong. This Thaneshwar is in the Haryana. Now open our culture, Indian culture booklet, page number 112. Indian culture booklet for IAS prelims 2020, page number 112. Here it is mentioned, Rohtak, Haryana, Thaneshwari. Rohtak is the site of many strong forts, and one of them was Thaneshwar or Thaneshwari. So Thaneshwar is in the Haryana. So fourth one is wrong. So you are left with option A, 1 and 3. A is correct. Question is solved. Next question. Now this is the question. Consider the following statements. 36% of India's districts are classified as overexploited. Central Groundwater Authority, CGWA, was formed under the Environment Protection Act. And third statement is that India has the largest area under the groundwater irrigation. Now take this second statement first, that CGWA was formed under the Environment Protection Act. The statement is correct. Open our July 2019 current affairs book, page number 38. This is our July 2019 current affairs book, page number 38 for IAS prelims. Here it is clearly mentioned that Central Groundwater Authority, CGWA, has been constituted under Section 3 of the Environment Protection Act 1986 for the purpose of regulation and control of groundwater development and management in the country. So statement 2 is correct. Now you have left with the two options that contains 2, B and C. Now check this third one. India has the largest area under the groundwater irrigation. This statement is wrong because India has the largest area under the canal irrigation. There is a difference between the groundwater irrigation and the canal irrigation. For this, open our geography book, page number 84. Our Indian geography book for IAS prelims 2020, page number 84. Here it is clearly mentioned on this chapter, irrigation, that India has one of the world's largest area under canal irrigation, not the groundwater. So this statement is wrong. Only two is correct. Statement first is also wrong, that 36% of India's districts are classified as overexploited or critical. For this, open our June 2019 current affairs book, page number 19, page number 85. June 2019 current affairs book, page number 85. There was a news, latest ground data reserves estimate soon. Here it is written that CGWA assessed 6584 units across the country and found only 253 to be critical and 1034 to be over exploited. So it is not the 36%. So this statement is also correct. This statement is also wrong. Third one is also wrong. Only two is correct. Therefore C is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. Among the following tiger reserves, which one has the largest area under the critical tiger habitat? And the correct answer is C, Nagarjuna Sagar, Shrelam. Now this is our Indian Environment booklet, page number 101, Indian Biodiversity, tiger reserves, and the first one is the Nagarjuna Sagar. It has the largest area, critical tiger habitat. The largest area is under the Nagarjuna Sagar. So C is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. This is the question. What is the advantages of zero tillage in agriculture? There are three statements. sowing of wheat is possible without burning the residue of the previous crop, that is the rice or paddy. This statement is correct. For this, kindly refer our August 2019 current affairs booklet. This is our booklet, August 2019 current affairs for rice prelims 2020, page number 111. There was a news with regard to the stubble burning. So from this news, the statement can be inferred easily that the Director General ICAR said that through the various efforts under the central scheme on the promotion of mechanization for in-situ management of crop residue in the states of Punjab, Haryana and UP, the paddy residue burning events have been reduced, and within 1 year of its implementation, the happy seeder or zero tillage technology was adopted in 8 lakh hectares. So sowing of wheat is possible under this zero tillage technology without burning the paddy. So the statement first is correct. Now you are left with two options, A and D, 1 and 2 and 1, 2, 3. Now take the third statement, that carbon sequestration in the soil is possible. This statement is also correct. For this, you have to refer our environment book, page number 31. This is our environment booklet, page number 31. Here it is clearly mentioned, the conservation of tillage on croplands, it increases the carbon storage through enhanced soil sequestration. It may reduce the energy-oriented CO2 emissions from the farm equipment. So conservation tillage on croplands, it increases the carbon storage through enhanced soil sequestration. So this statement is correct. 3 is correct. So 1 and 3, option that includes the 1 and 3, that is the D, 1, 2, 3. So D is the answer. Question is solved. And now the next question. Now take this question. The crop is subtropical in nature. It requires at least 210 frost-free days, 50 to 100 centimeters of rainfall. And the correct answer of this question is cotton. This is our geography book for IAS Prelims 2020. Page number 81. All the crops have been mentioned here. Cotton, it is a subtropical crop. Temperature, it requires above 21. 200 frost-free days. Rainfall less than 75 cm. Growing season, ragged soil is required. So all these are features of a cotton. All these are clearly mentioned. A is the answer. Question is solved. Now the next question. This is the question. Under the Kisan Credit Card Scheme, short-term credit support is given to the farmers for which of the following purpose? These 5 points are given. Now refer to our June 2019 current affairs booklets for IAS prelims, page number 20. There was a news, measures to provide easy loan to farmers, and in this it is clearly mentioned that government has introduced Kisan Credit Scheme, which enables farmers to purchase the agricultural inputs such as seeds, farmers, pesticides, but not tractors, and draw cash to satisfy their agricultural and consumption needs, but not to construct their houses. So see all these options. Working capital for maintenance of farm assets, that is correct. Purchase of combine harvesters, tractors, mini trucks, that is not correct. Consumption requirements of a farm households, that is correct. Post harvest expenses, that is correct. Construction of a family house, that is not covered. So options 1, 3 and 4 are correct. 1, 3, 4, B is the answer. Question is solved. Now the next question related to Indian economy. Consider the following statements. The first statement is that the weightage of food, that is primary articles, in the consumer price index is higher than that of a wholesale price index. This statement is correct. This is our Indian economy booklet for IAS prelims, page number 66. The difference between the consumer price index and the wholesale price index is given on the page number 67. It is mentioned that consumer price index, it gives higher weightage to the primary articles, 57%, that means the goods. So the statement one is correct. Now the second statement, that wholesale price index does not capture the changes in the price of services, which CPI does. This statement is also correct. On the same page of our Indian economy booklet, page number 66, it is mentioned that wholesale price index, it is used to measure the change in the average price level of goods traded in the wholesale market. And the consumer price index, it is used to measure the changes over time in the general level of price of goods and services, both. So statement 2 is correct, 1 is correct. Now check the third statement, that RBI has now adopted the wholesale price index as its key feature, as its key measure to inflation and to decide on the changing the key policy rates. This statement is wrong. In the same booklet, kindly refer to the page number 69, Indian Economy for IAS Prelims by bestcurrentaffairs.com, page number 69. Here it is clearly mentioned that RBI has been using the headline Consumer Price Index Inflation as a nominal anchor for monetary policy stance from April 2014 onwards. So statement 3 is wrong. 1 and 2 is correct. A is the answer. Question is solved. Now the next question. This is the question related to the rivers of the world. Consider the following pairs, rivers, flows into. Now take the first one, Mekong River. It says that it flows into Andaman Sea. This statement is wrong. This is our Indian, this is our geography booklet for IAS Prelims 2020. Page number 153. We have mentioned all the rivers of the world and their sources and their outflow. Now see. This Mekong River, that it flows into the South China Sea. Geography book by bestcurrentaffairs.com for IAS prelims, page 153. So the statement 1 is wrong. Now exclude the option 1 from the given answers. You are left with the B and C, 3 only or 3 and 4. Now take the fourth one, Zambezi River, it falls into the Indian Ocean. This statement is correct. This is our maps booklet that we provide for the IAS prelims exam in our combo course. Maps booklet by bestcurrentaffairs.com, page number 20. Now see, this Zambezi River, it falls into Indian Ocean. This statement is correct. So the statement 4 is correct. 3 and 4 are correct. C is the answer. Question is solved. This is the question. What is the importance of using the pneumococcal conjugate vaccines in India? First statement is that these vaccines are effective against the pneumonia. The statement is correct. Dependence on antibiotics against the drug resistance bacteria can be reduced. The statement is also correct. These vaccines have no side effects and cause no allergic reactions. This statement is wrong. So both 1 and 2 are correct. Now see our current affairs book, July 2020 current affairs for IAS prelims, page number 54. There was a news that indigenous vaccine for pneumonia gets nod. Drug Controller General of India has approved the first fully indigenous developed conjugate vaccine for pneumonia. So statement one is correct. Now the statement second, that dependence on drug resistance bacteria can be reduced. Now this is our current affairs book, November 2019, page number 90. There was a news that Indian vaccine to help control the typhoid in PAK. Pakistan is the first country in the world to introduce WHO's recommended typhoid conjugate vaccine in its national immunization program. And here in the last lines, that typhoid is caused by the Salmonella type E bacteria. A typhoid conjugate vaccine offers a good solution to protect children from falling ill and from the drug resistance typhoid, that is this bacteria. So statement 2 is also correct. 3rd is wrong. 1 and 2 are correct. B is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. This is the question. Which of the following statements are correct regarding the difference between the plant and animal cells? Statement 1 is that plant cells have cellulose cell walls whilst animal cells do not. This statement is correct. This is our science book for IAS prelims 2020, page number 45. Here you can see plant cell and animal cell. Plant cell have cell wall, animal cell do not have. So the statement one is correct. Second statement is that plant cells do not have a plasma membrane unlike animal cells do. The statement is wrong. They both have. Now again on the same page, this animal cell, it has this cell plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is also called cell membrane. Here also there is a cell membrane. So they both have. So the statement 2 is wrong. Now the third statement, that mature plant cell has one large vacuole whilst animal cell has many small vacuoles. This statement is also correct. From the same diagram you can see that plant cell, it has large central vacuole, and this animal cell, it has these very small vacuoles. So statement 3rd is also correct. 1 and 3 are correct. C is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. Which of the following are the reasons factors for the exposure to the benzene pollution? Automobile exhaust, tobacco smoke, wood burning. All these 5 are correct. All these are correct. Now open our environment book for IAS prelims 2020, page number 14. Pollutants, benzene pollution. So it is caused by carburetors, that is automobile exhaust, burning of fuels, that is wood burning, industrial processes involving solvents, industrial solvents, varnished, polyurethane, both these. Now the tobacco smoke is left. This benzene, it is also classified as a carcinogenic product. This is our science book, page number 11. Carcinogen, benzene, it has been classified as carcinogenic, and this carcinogenic, these are caused by tobacco smoke. So tobacco smoke is also there. All 5 are correct. D is the answer. Question is solved. Next question related to economy. If another global financial crisis happens, which of the following actions or policies are most likely to give some immunity to India? In times of any global financial crisis, the priority of the government is to hold their stock, money or foreign exchange reserves within the country. So the option one is that not depending on a short-term foreign borrowings. This statement is correct because this short-term foreign borrowings, they have a high interest rate and they put burden on the economy of a country. This is page number 101, Indian economy, for IAS Prelims 2020 by bestcurrentaffairs.com. External commercial borrowings. Here it is clearly written that interest rates on these borrowings are higher. The higher dependence on these borrowings can cause financial burden on the economy. So, not depending on foreign borrowings, it is recommended. So, point one is correct. Opening up to more foreign banks. This is not recommended because through these foreign banks, the foreign exchange reserve or money of the country can go to the other countries. So, it is not recommended. Third is maintaining full capital account convertibility. It is also not recommended. On the same book, page number 103, Indian Economy for IAS Prelims 2020. Page number 103, convertibility of a currency, capital account convertibility. It means free conversions of cross-border capital flows, implying that anybody can convert domestic currency into hard currency and take that currency out of that country for investing and opening account in some other countries or abroad. So it is not recommended. Again, go to our page number 21 of the same book for more explanation. Page number 21, Indian Economy book. Indian Economy for IAS Prelims 2020, page number 21. In 1997, a panel on capital account convertibility recommended that India move towards full convertibility by the year 2000. But the timetable was abandoned in the wake of 1997 East Asian financial crisis. So during the time of crisis, full capital account convertibility is not recommended. So this statement is wrong. Only one is correct. A is the answer. Question is solved. Now the next question. If you withdraw rupees 1 lakh in cash from your bank, the immediate effect on aggregate money supply in the economy will be? And the correct answer is unchanged. In this question, the words aggregate and economy needs the attention and the focus. Aggregate means the total money supply in economy of the country. There will be no immediate effect on the economy if a person withdraws that money from his bank, as this amount will be there with the economy of a nation. Open our Indian Economy book, page number 192. Here in money supply topic, the total stock of a money in economy, it is basically the currency held by the public plus money in the bank accounts. It consists primarily currency in the circulation and deposits in the saving and other accounts. So these are the various measures of money supply. These are referred to as a monetary aggregates. So in this question, if this condition took place, there will be no immediate effect on the economy. D is the answer. Question is solved. Now the next question related to history of India. With reference to the scholars of ancient India, consider the following statements. There are three statements. Now take the second statement first. Amar Singh was associated with the King Harshvardhan. This statement is wrong. This is our History of India book for IAS Prelims 2020, page number 43. Gupta period. This King Chandragupta II, he was a man of art and culture. His court was adorned by Navratna, including Amar Singh. So Amar Singh was with the King Chandragupta and not Harshvardhan. So statement 2 is wrong. Now remove the 2 from the given options. You are left with 3, C only. Kalidas is associated with Chandragupta 2. This is correct. In the same line it is written, Chandragupta 2, his court was adorned by Navaratna, including Kalidas, Amar Singh, Fahiyan, Acharya, Deen Ganga, etc. So 3 is correct, 2 is wrong, C is the answer, question is solved. Next question related to history of India. Wellesley established the Fort William College at Calcutta because, and the correct answer is that he wanted to train the British civilians for administrative purpose in India. This is our history book for IAS Prelims 2020, page 188. We have given the full chapter on education during the British rule, and here it is clearly written that they have opened several colleges and their purpose was to provide a regular supply of qualified persons to help in the administration of law in the courts of the company. So the correct answer is D. Question is solved. Next question. With the present state of development, artificial intelligence can effectively do which of the following activities? First one is the bring down the electricity consumption in the industrial units. It is correct. Create a meaningful short stories and songs. Meaningful. That is not correct. Disease diagnosis is correct. Text to speech conversion is correct. Wireless transmission of electrical energy. It is not correct. Now see our science book. Science book for IAS Prelims 2020, page number 2. We have given this complete explanation of this topic, artificial intelligence. It is a simulation of a human intelligence processes by machines, especially computer systems. These processes include learning, reasoning, and self-correction. Here is a list of applications of artificial intelligence. Now the first one is electricity consumption in industrial units. That is correct. That would be done with the help of power electronics and sensors. Second is disease. Third one is the disease diagnosis. Again on the same page. Diagnosis by artificial intelligence. This is correct. Text to speech conversion. On the same page. Speech recognition. That is also correct. Creation of a meaningful short stories. It is not correct. Similarly, wireless transmission of electrical energy. It is not correct. 1, 3, 4 are correct. 1, 3, 4. D is the answer. Question is solved. Next question. With reference to the visible light communication technology, which of the following statements are correct? Now there are four options. This is our June 2019 current affairs book, page number 146. It mentions about this technology. There was a news with the name of Li-Fi technology news. Li-Fi is a technology for wireless communication and it uses the visible light technology. This visible light communication technology. Li-Fi technology transmits data at a faster speed, at a very high speed. And this Li-Fi technology, it uses the visible light communications technology. Visible light communication works by switching the current to the LEDs off and on at a very high speed, too quick to be noticed by the human eye. Thus, it does not present any flickering. So now check the statements. Now take the second statement first, that VLC is known as a long-range optical wireless communication. The statement is wrong. It is not a long-range. Now the same news, you can see that Li-Fi technology, which is using this visible light communication technology, that lie, it covers the distance about 10 meters only. So 10 meters is not a very long range optical wireless communication. It is a short range wireless communication. So this statement is wrong. Now exclude the two from the given options. You are left with 1, 3, 4, C only. Now take the next statement, that VLC can transmit large amounts of data faster than Bluetooth. That is also correct. In the same news, UK, this meaning can be inferred from the same news, that Li-Fi is a technology. It transmits data at a very high speed. Li-Fi is a wireless. It uses the visible light communication, which has a much higher bandwidth. There was also a news in our August 2020 current affairs book, page number 69. New technology speeds up the organic data transfer. An international research team developed visible light communication setup capable of data range of 2.2 Mbps by employing a new type of OLEDs. So the statement that VLC can transmit a large amount of data faster, this statement is also correct. Third is that VLC has no electromagnetic interference, this statement is also correct. In the same June booklet, June 2019 booklet, page number 146, in the same Li-Fi news, it is mentioned that this Li-Fi technology, which is using the visible light communication technology, this Li-Fi technology can be widely used in the electromagnetic sensitive areas because this VLC has no electromagnetic interference. So the statement fourth is also correct. Third is also correct. First is also correct. In our August book, there was a news, August 2020 current affairs. We already showed you, page number 69. International research team developed a visible light communication setup capable of a data rate at 2.2 Mbps. It has a spectral range of 700 to 1000. This is the very latest new range, up to 780 nm. This is also correct. Second is wrong. So exclude 2, 1, 3, 4. They are correct. C is the answer. Question is solved.